Roll. See the connection there. It's like, okay. So when we think about interacting with the students as core group leaders, yes, you have your core group time, but also you have one-on-one time or one-on-two-or-three time that you interact with them at retreats and at special events. So there's a lot of different times and activities and environments where you're communicating and interacting with students. So I want to share with you a model that there's three different ways of looking at your role, and depending upon which role you're doing at that particular moment, you will communicate with them slightly differently. And those roles are, which one? What was that?
Coach.
Coach.
Referee.
Cheerleader. Coach,
and cheerleader, or ref, cheerleader, and coach. These are the three ones we're going to be talking about. Let's start with a very important question. Who is, turn to the person next to you, say, who is your favorite referee? Go. Uh-huh. Who's your favorite referee?
I have no idea.
All right, here's the question. I'm just curious, does anyone actually have a favorite referee?
I know who it is.
Was that? Was that saying it was not a relative? Now, if I were to say, who's your most loathed referee, everyone, of course, would go, Bill Levy, 2006. Yeah. Today, back here. That's right. And again, we have a different coach here, but also with the Steelers, oddly enough. In case you're curious, those of you, he was the referee, the 2006 of the Super Bowl, who basically cost us the Super Bowl. Because.
Amen.
But anyway, so when we say, who's your favorite referee, here's the interesting thing about roles. It's like, no one has a favorite referee. Now, can we play games without the referees and have them go well? No. It's a very needed, necessary role, but we don't like them. Except occasionally when I call penalties on the other team. But most of the time, we don't like them. Okay. Who's your favorite cheerleader? Go, talk to your favorite cheerleader. Okay, guys, if you actually have a name, that's a problem. Okay. Maybe you can say the Dallas cheerleaders outside of this room. But when you turn to your spouse and say, Amber, that's not good. Unless it's your daughter or something like that, then there you go. Now, generally, when you, here's another interesting thing. We don't have favorite individual cheerleaders, but the idea of cheerleaders is fantastic. I remember 1976, Brian Walter on the only sports team I ever played on in school, the very first time soccer ever came to Southern California in Orange County. We actually had to get the French teacher from Turkey to teach it because all the American coaches were like, what's that sissy sport our Europeans do? You don't use your hands, that's dumb. So here we are. So we're in ninth grade, and I remember our first game, and we're like, ha ha, and hair and everything. Oh, yes, and then suddenly it's like, cheerleaders are coming to our game. Because the fact that cheerleaders showed up made everything more exciting, more interesting. This was a bigger deal than we thought because cheerleaders came to our game and watched as we viciously beat the other team to a tie. 0-0. Okay. All right, now, who's your favorite coach? Turn to the person next to you and say, who is your favorite coach of all time? Could be a coach you've experienced, your daughter, or a professional coach. Who's your favorite coach of all time?
Tommy Lasorda.
Tommy Lasorda. Why Tommy Lasorda?
Because he believed in the great blue Dodger in the sky.
The great blue Dodger in the sky. All right. Who had a favorite coach at this table right here in the center?
Don James.
Don James. Don James. Thank you for reason, Don James.
He's just a great guy.
And they did well under his tenure here. All right. Table of Max. Any special at table of Max? Favorite coach of all time? Well, here's the interesting thing is all the other ones. Who's your favorite referee? Who's your favorite cheerleader? Who's your favorite coach? Probably about three quarters of us had a favorite coach. It might have been one we experienced personally or one that we respected. Even those of us who, like me, their sports experience prowess low, so didn't even have many personal sports experiences, we had a favorite coach. This is very significant for the model I'm going to be sharing. The different roles: referee, cheerleader, coach. Coach is the one that has the biggest impact, the one that we respect the most, and there's reasons for that. So let's kind of break it down a little bit. What does a referee do?
What's the rules?
Make the rules. Now here's the deal. Before you start a game, everybody agrees to play by the rules, even if they don't. They agree to the concept of, we're going to play by the rules. We accept the notion. To show up here, we're going to play by certain rules. We know what the rules are, but we know we live in an imperfect world, and so we're going to have referees to trust but verify. So, what is referee's job? Is to make sure the game gets played to the rules that we agree to, and they have power. Now, the first thing what a referee does is a referee stops the play when something illegal against the rules goes on. So suddenly I'm here, it's like, let's say, I'm in Spain, or if I'm in England, Manchester United. Ryan, you're playing soccer since you're football, sorry. And it's like, excuse me, lad, you just tripped your friend in a yellow card. Ben, you better watch it, I'm watching you. Stop, everybody, give him the ball, lad. Go, boom. He goes, okay. And then if you keep doing it, it's like, oh, okay. I blow the whistle and I run that real European way. You, you're out of the game. Because,
what?
Get up, no back talk, lad. Boom, he's out. Red card, you're out. Now, the great thing is also, other times, referees do their accepted penalties for less intense behavior. It's like, okay, there you go. 18-year-old Brian, yes, making out with your girlfriend behind the tents during summer safari. 10-yard penalty, boom! You will walk 10 yards away from her for the rest of the day. Boy, that was my flag there. And if I come by and I see sleeping bags, you're going home! There you go. We have accepted penalties. We stop the play. We give points to the other team. To give a timeout in hockey. These are getting rules again. If we don't have a referee, things go bad. There are times when you need to be the referee, and your communication is about stop, you need to think about it, stop, you need to go back a little, stop, we need to take you out of this situation. This is important communication. They will not love us for that. They will not remember us. It's like, oh, I remember those times when Ryan used to bust me all the time. No, that's not going to happen. But is it necessary? Absolutely. All right, what does a cheerleader do? What does a cheerleader do? Here's the interesting thing. Cheerleaders are always positive. They're rarely negative. It's like, let's go. Yay, we got an eye for interception that we lost. Woo! There are no cheers. It's like, you know, it's like, back up the truck. Our team sucks. I mean, they don't have cheers that do that. And it's like, they don't go to a professor. There's the seagulls going, the guy in room four, the section 42, scene four, he spilled his beer. Yay! On top of the person sitting next to him. I mean, they don't do that. It's always inherently positive. It waits till after something has happened and then oozes enthusiasm all for it. Yay, this thing was so exciting, yes! So they are an enhancer. They're an enhancer. They go to something that's already happened and they enhance it. Also, it's interesting, usually with cheerleaders, it's about their recognizing group accomplishments. Not always, but usually it's about group things. Something cool happened and it's like, yay, team. You don't usually hear cheers about, yay, Bob Johnson, number 34. Yay, Barbara, who just spiked it. I mean, it's usually that yay about the team. Interesting distinction we'll get to. And finally, what does, oops, that should be a coach. Wait, real time. Here we go. Dun, coach, here we go. Dun. What does a coach do? There we go. Boom. As I was saying. And then there's the lesson, what does a coach do? What does a coach do? So tell me.